It's all orchestrated too well.
Huh?
The fleet deployment came too quickly. They must have been prepared to ensure that Momo would return to them, regardless of what happened. Or perhaps ensnaring Second Milsha was part of their plan from the very beginning.
As a neutral territory, Second Milsha was invested with a whole bunch of rights and legal privileges after the Milshan conflict. There are a whole lot of folks who still have problems with that. Even outside of the UTIC organization.
The asteroid where Momo was imprisoned. I wondered where the information about that place came from. Now it seems like it was all part of the plan from the very beginning.
Do you mean from when Mommy sent you to rescue me?
You don't think there are UTIC members within the subcommittee itself?
It's not inconceivable. Perhaps it was the very person who arranged for Momo's rescue, Dr. Yuri Mizrahi herself.
No! Mommy would never do something like that!
Alan!
Sorry.
Open it.
Helmer?
Sorry to keep you waiting, Guinan. I'm in a somewhat difficult position myself at the moment, but I'm doing what I can with the Federation Parliament.
Now the woman beside you is Captain Lapis Roman. Several years ago, I sent her to infiltrate the military in order to keep tabs on the UTIC members within it. She is one of my most trusted subordinates.
Always prepared, aren't you?
Caution is something that comes naturally with age.
Captain Roman will investigate the Durandal's records before someone modifies them. Please assist her.
Understood.
I'll give her the Durandal's master key.
Sir. There's an EPR comm from the CEO of Vector.
Vector? All right, I'll take it. If you'll excuse me, I'll let you know if there are any developments.
Busy as always.
Not half as much as you.
It's good to see you again, Representative Helmer.
Likewise, Mr. Wilhelm. We haven't spoken since you resigned as Executive Committee Director.
I'm well aware of the situation. Allow me to make a recommendation to the Parliament as well.
Mr. Wilhelm, you're too kind.
Actually, my concerns have even prompted me to dispatch the Damerung, which is currently underway to the Milshan system.
Your concerns?
This incident. Surely you've realized by now that...
There's no question of the UTIC organization's involvement in it.
Exactly. Given that, it can only mean they're after one thing. The original Zohar in stasis on Milsha and...
Udu.
We can't allow that to be awakened again.
I believe our firm's Cosmos and its related staff are currently in your care.
I apologize, Mr. Wilhelm. I'm afraid the link between the Kukai Foundation and the Second Milshan government is...
Ah, of course. Then please pass a message on to Guinan for me. Surely that would be acceptable.
That much I can do.
Tell him that we'll lend him Cosmos for a while, and he can use her as he sees fit. We still have time before the Zohar project commences, and in the worst-case scenario, she'll definitely be of use. We'll have the 2nd R&D Division and the Tactical Sim Lab provide support.
Are you sure?
Isn't that top secret?
It's a calculated risk. From our point of view, the more real-world data we get, the better.
All right. I'll convey your message to Master Guinan.
Thank you. Good day, then.
Udu.